Welcome to This Is My Architecture. We are at reInvent. My name is Gerardo, and I'm joined today by Rob from Formula One. Welcome, Rob.
Thank you.
So, Rob, tell us, what are you doing at Formula One these days?
I'm consulting for Formula One. Yeah. I've got a strange title of technical consultant. Mm-hmm. And I'm trying to help Formula One. You know, we've got a mission in Formula One to try to help the sport, make the sport more entertaining, more engaging, more immersive for the fan. So I'm bringing, I spent 25 years in the teams, and I'm trying to bring some of that experience to the live broadcast, to the way that we convey Formula One to the fans.
To make the sport more engaging for your fans, is that right?
Yeah. We're trying to use, you know, as engineers in Formula One, mm-hmm. our lifeblood is data analytics. It's data. It's using data. It's using, you know, classical algorithms. It's using machine learning. And in order to do that we use that to make the car go faster. We use that to find performance. We want to use that is I want to bring some of that to the fan base so that when they're watching it, you know, they understand those key moments of the race.
So today you're telling us about the pit strategy battle. Is that right?
That's right.
Can you explain for the viewers that are not familiar with racing, what is that?
So the pit strategy battle was something that we did in our partnership with AWS. To make these Formula One insights. And essentially what it is this the race strategy of a Formula One race really frames the whole race. It's the most important part of the race. Even can be more important than the wheel-to-wheel action that you see on the track. Yeah. And one of the key parts of that is something that we call the undercut. So when you've got two cars going around the track together, mm-hmm. and they're about ready to make that, what you know, a pit stop. Yeah. If the car behind pulls into the pits, he's kind of pulled the key advantage there because he's going to put some new tires on, and then he's going to get a lap on new tires, while the guy in front who stayed out, he stays out on the old tires.
And you're sharing those insights with viewers in the broadcast.
And we're trying to share that insight to try to tell the viewers about, you know, what's going to happen, you know, whether or not the guy behind is going to get in front, you know, what the probability is. So we're pulling all of the data that we've got, and we're pushing it through machine learning models and trying to give that insight to the viewer.
This is really good. Can you walk us through what's under the hood?
Okay, so what's under the hood is, so this is the car. This is the car going around the track. Yeah. So you've got the car and the car telemetry and timing transponder. And that comes back up to our data center in Biggin Hill here. Okay, that's stored there. And then we take it via the API gateway across into the machine learning part here. Okay, so the API, we use the API to extract the data into lots and lots of different areas. Yeah. And then from the API gateway, we essentially process that data. So and we're using Lambda functions. So we're now completely, you know, this is AWS that we sit over here. So this is Formula One, Biggin Hill, the data center. Yeah. And then this has now gone into all the work that AWS are doing. So we process the data. We essentially synchronize it and we make sure that the timing data matches the timestamp on the timing data matches the car data. That then gets stored across here in DynamoDB. Mm-hmm. You know, and there's kind of a two-way thing here. And then again down here we've got this into the app data into S3. Yeah. This essentially now is we're getting into the crux, which is that the most important part is AWS SageMaker, because that's the bit that's doing everything.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is
what are you doing with SageMaker?
So we're training and we're deploying. Okay. So we use SageMaker and we've built two we've built two machine learning algorithms, mm-hmm. Models. One is the on-track model, and the other one is the pit lane model.
Okay.
And then eventually, essentially, from S3 and from here, we take the situation, we take the real-time data, mm-hmm. and then we check that against the train data, and we come up with the stats. So we're able to then use the SageMaker at that point to tell us whether or not the car's going to be in front or behind, what the probability is.
That's really good. So you're training and experimenting with a lot of models, and when you're happy with the accuracy of a model, then you deploy it, and that's what you use for the live stream. Is that right?
That's right. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So once we're happy that SageMaker is giving us an accurate answer, or as accurate as you can be, because obviously it's a sport. Yeah. There's so many different parameters. You know, we can only give you know, to a certain accuracy, what we think is going to happen.
Yeah.
But up to now, actually, I've got to say it's been very, very accurate. This is the most, you know, this has been an absolute revolution for Formula One. Yeah. Then we push it across here to the broadcast center. So this is the track. This is UK.
Yeah.
This is now our virtual cloud space, and this is now back to the track at the broadcast center, and then eventually from the track it gets pushed up here to the broadcast feed, and you get, and it gets put on the television.
And then your viewers can enjoy those insights.
Yes, exactly.
This is amazing. Can you tell us about the benefits that the Formula One fans are getting for on the back of this implementation?
Well, look, just this one insight that we're trying to give them.
Yeah.
We're educating Formula One fans about what we call the off the ball action. So you've got the cars going around on the track, which is, you know, the international feed, or if you watch it on the television, you know, whoever the broadcaster is, you see the cars going around the track. But there's so many more interesting insights and data points that are going on away from that action, and this is what we're trying to tell them here. So this is a perfect example. You've got two cars which can be 2-3 kilometers away from each other on the track, but we're trying to distill that and show what it's going to be like, you know, in 30 seconds time.
This is amazing, Rob. So I love how Formula One has been at the cutting edge of technology for car performance, but now you're also bringing that to improve the engagement with your users. Thank you very much for sharing this architecture with us.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching. This is My Architecture. We'll be right back.